In today's video, you're going to learn everything that you need to know about strokes in Adobe Illustrator, because I have a comprehensive guide on strokes when working in Illustrator. So another awesome resource for learning essential skills as a graphic designer is Skillshare. Now, Skillshare is a community of creators that holds over 25,000 classes on design, business, and other useful topics. And regarding graphic design, Skillshare boasts a wide selection of courses by professionals in their respective fields. You can learn more about Skillshare and how to get 2 months totally for free later in today's video. Welcome back to Satori Graphics, and today I have a comprehensive guide on strokes in Adobe Illustrator. Now, if you feel that you do know strokes pretty well, stay tuned anyway, because you probably will learn something in today's video, even if you are quite accustomed to using strokes. So firstly, what is a stroke? It basically is a line of color that precisely follows a vector path. Now, the vector path is seen in the middle here of the blue line, and this is just the data that tells Illustrator where an object or a line is. The stroke is the line that follows this vector path. Now, you can find the stroke color in the color palette here, and you can double click this to change its actual color. You can also come up here to the top to increase or decrease the actual size of your stroke. So that's what a stroke essentially is. But now let's look at the different ways that you can actually apply the stroke to the vector path. This is the standard way to apply a stroke to a vector path, with the vector being in the middle of the stroke. However, we can actually go ahead and open the stroke window and change things somewhat. You can find the stroke window here, or in the top drop-down menu. So as I mentioned before, the vector path is in the middle of the stroke here, but on this circle, you will notice that the stroke falls on the inside. The stroke is around the circle shape here. And lastly, on this shape, the stroke is aligned on the outside of the shape. So that's something to bear in mind, and it will come in handy on different types of designs, and you know where to find it in the stroke window. Now, another handy and a neat function built right into Illustrator is the ability to change the style of the corners and the ends of your paths. Within the stroke window, you can see that the line has a butt cap, and this is the default setting for a stroke line. The second line utilizes a round cap, which obviously results in the line being rounded at the very end. And the third setting is a projected cap, which essentially is a butt cap that kind of extends out from the vector line itself. When you're editing the corners of your stroke lines, you can come here back into the stroke window and either use the default setting, the round setting, and also finally a bevel setting. Notice how the corners of my shape change with each different setting. So when using strokes in Adobe Illustrator, a super handy tool to use in combination is the width tool. And you can find that here, or you just need to press the keyboard shortcut of Shift and W. While using the width tool, you will notice a plus icon that appears here when you hover the width tool over a stroke line. You can then click and drag to either increase or decrease the stroke weight on a specific part of your line. You can also double click the line, which is going to bring up this menu box here, allowing you to make adjustments with greater precision on your stroke paths. Now, the width tool is especially handy for things like digital illustrations and also, you know, things like logo designing and so forth. Now, Illustrator has some built-in presets for stroke styles, and you can find those here. Now, another function that is found within the stroke menu itself is the dashed line setting. Now you simply need to click your vector path and then check the dashed line box. The first value here is going to determine the size of each dash, and then the second value is going to determine the gap between each dash itself. You can also choose to arrange the dashes evenly around your entire shape, or you can align them to the corners. But do keep in mind that adjusting the stroke weight while having your dashed lines activated will produce differing results. So yeah, thanks again to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. You can use their useful courses for 2 months totally for free if you use my link down in the description box below. Now this is going to allow you to have access to high-end classes and tutorials made by successful and professional people in their relative fields. So do be sure to check out Skillshare link down below and learn some new techniques and some new skills today. The Illustrator tutorial that you've just seen was more geared towards beginners, and that's not something I tend to do on my channel so often, but I think sometimes it is necessary. But yeah, do let me know what you want to see on my channel, and of course, if you want to keep learning essential skills in graphic design, do subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Have an awesome day, everyone, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.